He wins the million, but by winding up fourth by about a head behind the two others, it's Bet Twice who not only wins the race, takes the purse, but takes the $1 million triple crown bonus as well. And there he was crossing the finish line.
By Sportin' Life out of Golden Dust.
Now the start, looking down with Bet Twice and Ali Sheba, and it was Bet Twice who got off to the slower of the starts between the two.
Gone West actually toward the rail came out a little bit into Avey's Copy, but it was Avey's Copy and Gone West who scooted right on up there around the first turn.
So the results are official. Bet Twice is the winner.
Chris, a little disappointment, I'm sure.
Huh? Yeah, big disappointment.
We wondered in the turn there if you ever considered claiming foul at all.
No, I really didn't. I think that incident was probably my fault. My colt didn't respond for me the way I expected him to down the backside. When Craig asked his colt to advance a little bit, I tried to go right with him, and my horse just didn't show the immediate response he's done in the past. And when Crypto Clearance went by me on the turn, Lafitte was smart enough to float me down in there a little bit behind Gone West. And as a last resort, I reached over and hit my horse left-handed a few times and gave him a few good whacks, and he finally starts running. But then just as he started running, Gone West was stopping directly in front of me. And with Crypto Clearance right there on the outside, I had no chance but to steady.
Was your horse a little different than he was in the Preakness and the Derby today?
Well, around the first turn, he was really wanting to run. And I feel I might have discouraged him a little bit by taking so much hold of him. But my concern was try to get to the outside.
As far as you know, he didn't bleed, did he?
No, sir, not from the nostrils anyway. Mm-hmm.
Well, you lost $1 million just by about a head, too. Isn't that awful?
It's terrible.
But I have a feeling you're going to see you and Bet Twice are going to hook up again in a good duel.
I certainly hope so. That colt's a good colt, and those people deserve all the congratulations.
Thank you very much, Chris.
Thank you.
Jim?
All right, Jack, thank you very much. A few words from Chris McCarron there. I'm standing with Tom Bancroft, the chairman of the New York Racing Association, and, of course, with the winners, Bob Levy here, his wife, Sissy, trainer Jimmy Kroll back here, jockey Craig Perrett, and what is this young lady's name?
Jennifer, that's my daughter. That was my biggest rooter today.
What do you think, Jennifer? Jennifer shrugged. Tom, the moment has come to present the trophy for the Belmont Stakes, the 119th running.
Well, Bob, you and your crew went to their first two races. Your horse ran a terrific race. You came back today and just slaughtered the field. Congratulations on winning the Belmont. Let's hold this up so everybody can see it. There you go. There's the trophy.
The trophy for the Belmont Stakes. Bob, as you came up here, you mentioned to me that today would have been the 90th birthday of your dad, Leon Levy. He's got to be smiling somewhere.
He sure is, Jim, because this would have been a big thrill for him.
Sissy?
He's watching, I guarantee it, and he's got a big smile on his face. Happy birthday, Leon.
Craig, congratulations to you. What a marvelous ride.
Thank you. I thought I did it well, too. No, just all jokes aside, you know, the colts give us a lot of fun, and, you know, he was 2 seconds in fighting races, and he deserves to win one.
No question about that. Jimmy, congratulations to you. You've had a long career, but this is the big one, isn't it?
Thank you, Jim. It was really a lot of fun. We were 2 seconds, but just made up for it.
What were the instructions to Craig before the race?
Craig rode the horse exactly like I asked him.
Okay, well, then I guess why don't we come over here and take a look at the replay, Craig. Yes, Bob.
I just think Jimmy Kroll deserves all the credit in the world. This is a great training job to get this horse this far, and he really deserves it. All we do is get the trophies, and he did all the work.
Okay, Jimmy, congratulations again. Craig, come here. We're going to pick it up, if you will, at the half-mile pole and take a look at the race from there on. Would you describe it for us? You got the slow fractions. Did you want slow fractions?
Well, you know, we was going to play it by ear. We wasn't going to take my colt back, and it was going to the first turn, decided where I wanted to be. When them first two horses inside of me wanted to take it, I was comfortable sitting off of him. You know, Bet Twice is the kind of colt, when you call on him, he's going to do some running for you. I was comfortable. I was right off about 4 lengths off them horses. I had him in a part of the track I wanted to. And the only tactics we changed with him today is when I decided to go to him, I wasn't going to ease to him. When I hooked him, I was going to let him run. And he opened up, and he got the money today.
Do you have to be aware of the length of this racetrack when you're coming over to Belmont?
Yeah, but when a type of colt like he is, he don't give up. Even when he's not finishing hard, he's still going in 12 and change. If you notice today, inside the 70-yard pole, they had all the cameras. He ducked just like he did in the Derby. if you recall the incidents. But he was far enough away from his horses, it didn't matter. But he gets a tendency to want to notice things inside of him. And he did that today, but he got far enough away from his field to where I was just going to stay busy with him.
No worries at this point, or were you still concerned?
At the 3-8 pole, I really wasn't worried because he kicked easy for me. He opened up on his horses without me putting him to a drive. And I knew when I got inside the quarter pole, I says, if Ali Sheep is 100%, he might get him, but that's what it would take today. And as we see, I guess he wasn't.
The margin is somewhat reminiscent of a horse named Secretary. Remember, that was 31, but yours was certainly convincing today. We're going to have another presentation now, Craig, so if we could all step back over here.
Jim.
First, we're going to look at the complete order of finish, Bob, if we may. Okay, complete order of finish, official order. The result is official now. And here it is. Bet Twice, the winner. Crypto Clearance was second. Gulch was third. Ali Sheba, fourth. Chocolate One was fifth, and the rest of the field. Gone West, sixth. Avi's Copy, seventh. Manasseh Jack was eighth, and he did beat one horse. He beat Leo Castelli. All right, we have one more break to take here. That's what we're going to do right now, and then come back for another presentation. The presentation of the $1 million bonus for the Triple Crown points.
I'm at the Triple Crown. Today, he certainly squared the accounts by a huge margin. Wide World of Sports Sunday edition comes your way at 11 o'clock with Max and Lou, the British Ice Dance Championships at 1 o'clock, Sports Sunday between 4 and 6, and then the French Open men's final tonight at 11. If you stay with 9, you can bet on a top sporting coverage. In fact, you can bet twice.
Tuesday, the kid throw away.